Do you want to learn how you can send your tracing data to Grafana Cloud using Alloy, but you don't know where to start? Well, you're in luck because in this video, I'm going to show you how to do just that. My name is Marie Cruz, and in this Grafana Learning Journey video, I'll show you how you can install and configure Grafana Alloy to start tracing data to Grafana Cloud. I'll also show you how you can use the Grafana Alloy UI to understand and monitor your telemetry pipelines. And finally, I'm going to show you how you can verify that your tracing data appears correctly in Grafana Cloud. But before any of that, there are a few prerequisites that you need to know. First, you need to have a Grafana Cloud account. Next, you need to have an instrumented application that already generates tracing data. In this video, I'll be using this very simple Node.js project that rolls a dice. And this is already instrumented using OpenTelemetry. If you don't have any instrumented application, you can set up any of the sample applications from OpenTelemetry to help you get started. Finally, you need to have Tempo up and running, whether that's locally installed or using the Grafana Cloud Traces. In this video, I'll be using Grafana Cloud Traces. So feel free to pause this video, especially if you're setting up all the prerequisites. But when you're ready, let's get right into it. So in this milestone, we're going to look at how you can install Alloy on your local machines. So we have different instructions depending on your operating system. I'm on a Mac OS, so I'm going to use Homebrew, but if you're using Ubuntu, Docker, or you know Windows, we also have instructions for those systems. So I'm going to stick with Mac OS, but if you also want to run Grafana Alloy as a standalone binary, you can follow the instructions here. Okay, so first I'm going to copy the first script to add the Grafana Homebrew tab. Next, where I'm going to copy the install Grafana Alloy. I've already installed mine, so the installation is quite quick, but if this is your first time that you're doing it, it might take a while. Next, I'm going to start the Grafana Alloy as a service. To verify if Alloy is up and running, you can also run this command. If you encounter any issues with the installation, let us know in the comments down below and we'll redirect you to the correct resource. In this milestone, you're going to learn how to configure Alloy so you can start sending tracing data to Grafana Cloud. The Alloy configuration file defines how the Alloy workflow should look like. It's a collection of different Alloy components. In Alloy, a component is simply a building block that does one specific job in terms of collecting, processing, and sending telemetry data. Now, I'm going to show you how you can update the Alloy configuration file, but first, we need to locate our Grafana Cloud credentials and create an API token with the correct write permissions to configure Alloy. To do that, I'm going to go to my Grafana Cloud stack. Next, I'm going to click the Details button next to my Grafana stack name. I'm going to scroll down and go to the Tempo section, and I'm going to click Details or the Send Traces. Now, if I scroll down to the Sending Data to Grafana Cloud using Grafana Alloy section, you can see that there is an example Alloy configuration file here that we can use instantly. So the next thing that we need to do is we need to locate where our config.alloy is. Now, depending on your operating system, the location would be different. Since I'm on a Mac OS, the location of my config.alloy file would be here. But if you're on Linux or on Windows, it is here. So now I'm going to open the Alloy configuration file with my VS Code editor. So I'm just going to copy this pod location and we're going to type in code and the location pod. Now that the configuration file is open, I'm going to copy the example configuration here and then paste that here, save the file, and then I need to generate a Grafana API token with the correct write permission. So to do that, I'm going to click generate now. I'm just going to give it a name, Marie Traces Demo, set expiration of tomorrow, and I'll just click create token. And I'm going to copy that and add that to my Alloy configuration file. So that's all configured, but what are these components? So the first component is the autocall.receiver.opentelemetryprotocol or OTLP. So this component basically accepts the telemetry data such as traces from other OTL components and forwards them to other components. So in this case, it's going to be forwarded to this Grafana Cloud Alloy component. Next, the autocall.exporter.opentelemetryprotocol component will basically send the tracing data received from this component to our Grafana Cloud Traces backend. And then finally, this component here just configures the basic authentication for Grafana Cloud. So now that we've done that, how do we tell Alloy of these new changes? We'll look at that in the next milestone. In this milestone, we're going to look at restarting the Alloy service so that the latest changes that we've done is going to take into effect. So to do that, I've copied the brew services restart command and it should say successfully stop and started Alloy. Then let's go to localhost port 12345, which displays the Grafana Alloy UI. The Grafana Alloy UI is a lightweight built-in web interface provided by Alloy so that you can monitor and debug your telemetry data, look at the health of your components, and just debug any of your data pipelines. Clicking the graph tab, you can see how the components are all interconnected. And if we click one component, so in this case, we're looking at the component that does the basic authentication, you can see that the username and password have been set as arguments. Now, the final step is to verify that the traces appear correctly in Grafana Cloud. Let's look how that works in the final milestone. To view the traces, let's run our instrumented application and roll a few dice. Then let's look at Grafana Alloy UI. So now you can see that there's data flowing in through the different components. And now if I go back to my Grafana Cloud stack, go to explore, click search, and let's just change the time range to last 5 minutes and run our query. And there you go, you can see that all the tracing data generated from the DICE application has now been sent to Grafana Cloud. Well done for completing this learning journey. In this video, you learned how to send your tracing data from your instrumented applications to Grafana Cloud. If you enjoy this type of learning, then why don't you head over to grafana.com/docs/learningjourneys for other similar topics. I hope you enjoyed watching and I'll see you at the next one.